Hi, everybody. It's Robin here. Thanks, guys, for joining me on Oracle Rising. You guys are such a blessing, and thank you for all your comments and everybody for subscribing. Thank you so much. So this is sort of a video basically for empaths, but anybody else that is a sensitive person, light workers, star seeds, you guys, anybody that is in need of a little bit of extra protection. If you're feeling frazzled, there's also some really good tips here related to herbs and helping you out. So I'm thinking something along the lines of you might have an outdoor space where you can use this, but for all year use, depending on your climate, you might want to get yourself like a little indoor herbal garden. Some of these things might even come in a tablet form, like a supplement. So hopefully this is going to help you out. I just did a video recently about taking on a little bit of too much collective energy, which is almost impossible to do, especially if you're going out in the world at all. And you know what? The internet is picking up collective energy as well. Okay. So if you're on any form of social media, any type of interaction can leave you feeling spent and drained and like regretful and shaken. So let's start talking about these herbs. I've got, I think six. Yeah, six. It's the magic number. So the first one I have is St. John's wort. And this one I know to be a supplement as well. Okay. So herbs, you could probably find them at your local garden shop or whatever. And some of them you might be able to find at a grocery store as well. Okay, so St. John's wort specifically protects against negative energy. And there's so much negative energy. If you guys watch the news, which please stop doing, you know, unless you really need an important update, it's just so draining. Negative energy is everywhere, and you can pick up collective energy just from people's thoughts. This is why it's really important to keep your thoughts high, your thoughts in a positive manner, because what you think you attract. So if you're thinking negative thoughts, really try the following phrase: cancel, clear, delete, and think something happy, or listen to a happy song, or hug your dog or your cat or your partner if you have one. So I really like this one, and it also does help in keeping your vibration high. Okay, so I feel like I heard, and you guys can confirm this in the comments too, St. John's wort might also help with memory function, particularly as you age. I know a lot of people that do take it as a supplement. So the second one I have here, and this sounds really nice, is lemon balm. Okay, B-A-L-M, not O-M-B. So this restores your nervous system, okay? So I was talking in a recent video how I have to go out to a laundromat and I would just feel like my nerves were shot after I was leaving there. So imagine if you could come home and be around something that you could do a little satchel, you could use all of these herbs, and you could put in some spices if you like to make it smell good, like cinnamon. Where was I going with that? You could make a potpourri, you know. I wonder if there's also incense in these, like that are actually made with these natural ingredients, or you could get a sage, okay? Well, sage is sage, like a smudge stick that could be made with alternative herbs that is not a sage. But anyway, restores your nervous system. So you could go and sit by your potpourri or go stand by your little herbal garden. You could probably clip some of these and put them into your bath as well, but I would really make sure that you check out for allergic reactions before you soak your entire body into an herbal bath, okay? Because you don't want to be having some sort of allergic reaction. An alternate too is to hang an herbal remedy into your shower, okay? So it releases the benefits, but you're not bathing in it. So this also heals energetic wounds, okay? So when you think of energetic wounds, you want to think of like somebody that is a gaslighter, okay? They really harm your energy. Narcissist, you want to think of sociopaths, energy vampires, you know, just anybody that lives to drain the energy of a high vibrational person, okay? So that was lemon balm for you guys. Now, thyme, okay? It helps with channeling guides, okay, which is absolutely amazing, and communicating beyond the veil, okay? So this is huge for those of you that are trying to communicate with your guides. Maybe you're feeling blocked or you're just not having any type of success. So channeling your guides, they should be readily available and accessible to you. I know some people, like for myself, I use a tarot card deck or an oracle card deck to help channel the guides. I don't usually have a problem, you know, at all channeling guides, and communicating beyond the veil comes very, very easy for some people. Like my friend Amanda, she is a psychic medium, and she saw somebody around me just when we were on FaceTime. I didn't even ask her about it, but she's so keenly aware that she just saw somebody. Okay, so time can really help you out with that. Again, you know, you could have a satchel or maybe a time incense or something like that. That's THYME. Don't burn your watches, guys. So this other one here, the next one is called Ruda, and this helps block energy vampires and psychic attacks. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I did an entire video on psychic attacks. This is where you just really start to doubt yourself, you know, you're just not in control of your thoughts anymore, which is pretty scary, because when you think that, you know, everything that you think becomes your reality, if you're under a psychic attack and your thoughts are no longer your own and you're being controlled by, you know, some sort of a negative master race, which is the keepers of the 3D matrix, this one is hugely important, Ruda. Okay, so I've never seen this live and in person, but I'm also not a plant person, even though I'm a vegan. Go figure. But like, I'm just a horrible gardener, so I don't have any of this stuff in my house. I use more traditional, I guess it's all traditional, but I do like shielding and grounding. But this could be really helpful if you're not into the chi ball shielding or doing any sort of grounding, or it's too cold outside and you're a plant person. This could really help you out. Okay, so blocking energy vampires, because you don't know who out there is an energy vampire until you walk away from them, unless you're really highly perceptive. And as empaths, here's the thing about empaths. We're natural born healers, so you're going to attract people in need of healing, okay? So it is a double-edged sword being an empath. You're really here to help heal the collective, but it can really just suck the life out of you, you know? And you're drawing in these people, like I was talking about before, especially energy vampires and gaslighters. And then you're like, what is happening here? And you're so sensitive that you might just really get sucked into their way of thinking. Okay, so Ruda can really help you out with that. Passion flower. Okay, so this is just an overall protection for extra sensitive people. Okay, so something that I was thinking about here too, I don't know if any of these come in an essential oil, because this could be really helpful where you could make a little bit of a body spray out of it. So you could definitely do that with thyme, because, well, all of them, you could just sort of soak the herbs in hot water and then pour it into a bottle and spray it. You could spray it around your home too, and spray it on your body, you know, spray it in your hair, because we really need protection when we're out there, because we're super susceptible, even though we do everything to protect ourselves. And if your energy is low already and you have to go out into the matrix, or you're out, like you're just on the internet or something, you're highly susceptible already as an empath. Okay, so, and passion flower, it sounds like it smells really nice. So protection for extra sensitive people. I really recommend a body spray. I'm not sure how thyme would smell. Maybe you just smell like somebody cooking a turkey, but anyway. So cat's claw, I like the sound of that because I'm a Catterday person so much. Helps release blockages and negative energy, okay? So I really like the sounds of that. You know, it helps release blockages because I think we pick them up along the way. We could also be dealing with, I just saw angel number 919 and my guides asked me to call that out for you guys. So you could just look that up, angel number 919 on the internet, and see what the translation is for you from our angel guides. Okay, so help release blockages. We could receive those at a very, very early age, and then we can just keep on receiving them throughout life. So I really like that one for you, especially if you guys are stalled in your manifestation process. You don't know why you're not able to you know, manifest something, or you're just on a really like boring, long ass plateau of mundaneness, but I don't even think that's a word, so we'll carry on. And releases negative energy. So again, I mean, you could do whatever you want, okay? Whatever works for you. And while I have you guys here, I live in Manitoba in Canada, and I'm not even kidding when I tell you guys that our provincial bird is the mosquito. And because we're talking about herbs, I'm gonna give you guys a natural mosquito repellent, and you can make this into a spray, okay? And it's super easy to do. All you have to do is go to the grocery store and pick up a sprig or two of rosemary, a couple really nice juicy lemons, and make sure that you have vanilla, okay? The liquid vanilla, like as if you were baking, okay? So you would cut the lemons into slices or wedges or whatever and line the bottom of a bowl. Actually put the rosemary in first so it doesn't float. Boil your kettle and make sure the bowl can sustain boiling water, okay? Don't put it in a really thin glass bowl. Make sure it's something really solid, okay? And then pour boiling water over it. You can pour as much as you want. It depends on how many bottles you fill up. You maybe want to make one for your neighbor or something like that. I usually do. And then you pour like a little bit of vanilla on top of that, and you just let it cool, okay? So you can stir it around. And then it's friendly for your animals as well. Just make sure you don't spray them in the face. I actually cover Lacey whenever she needs to go outside. I'm surprised she didn't perk up when I said that, but she's sleeping. And I spray it on myself too, because I'm not a fan of having mosquito bites, okay? They're very, very itchy. So really try that out. And you can spray your patio or your deck or whatever, you know, and it should really help repel them. There are some other natural sort of insect repellents as well, like if you're afraid of wasps and bees like I am. like something like vinegar and lemon essential oil will work, or a peppermint essential oil. You can look those recipes up, because things that I don't like to put on myself are the sprays that you can pick up at whatever store that they're repellents or whatever, okay? Because you don't know what else is in them. If you get them in your face or in your eyes, I mean, it's just really not healthy. Can be really bad for your pets. You want to think of, like, if you have a pet and you're spraying your body with an insect repellent, and you know, they come up and they put their face on you or something like that, it could really transfer to them. It could be very, very toxic. So just really look at natural ways of healing yourself, you guys, and for protecting your energy, especially if you're an empath, because we really need you here and we really need you to be strong. So that's my video for today, guys. And thank you so much for being here. I'll see you back here another time. Namaste, guys. Bye. Bye.